Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be an incredibly informative and powerful transmission today. We got a call yesterday from Lindsey Williams, literally short of breath. And in the last few days, he talked to his former head of a major big three oil company who has attended Bilderberg meetings and such. And the intel he's given us, about 90% of it has turned out to be absolutely accurate. Including, you know, 6 months before oil went from $50 a barrel to $149, Lindsey Williams called it exactly from his source, and then he said it was going to go down, and it went down. Just total precision on so many fronts, and he called us. His source is dying, has terminal cancer, and completely spilt his guts to him. So, by the way, I know who the person is. Dr. Stan Monteef checked it for himself and was able to figure it out and called the person a few years ago when all this first broke. So Lindsey is certainly telling the truth about this source. The question is, you know, is somebody feeding the source disinfo? And the evidence, unfortunately, shows that they're not. So this is amazing what the globalists are planning according to this. What's coming up with Russia and China, Iran, the mortgages, crude oil, back to $150, $5 a gallon gas within 8 months, gold and silver won't slow down, will skyrocket from this point. And then he has a separate contact that had dinner with Janet Napolitano and what she told him. She said, get 6 months of food and water ready now. So, Lindsey Williams joining us in the next hour. And coming up in about 12 minutes, 14 minutes from now, we've got Wayne Madsen popping in. I could have Madsen or Tarpley on the subject. They're both experts. So am I, quite frankly, for that matter, studying this over the years, but I want to get their view on it. It's big exclusive. Big exclusive. In fact, Paul Watson didn't even toot his horn on this. I want you to get Watson on the line at the start of the next segment. I want to briefly give him today's directive because I want Paul to toot his horn. Not that, oh, Paul Watson's great or Alex Jones is great. We need to point out we already told you this going back 4 years ago. We identified this guy as their top Al-Qaeda operative controlled by the CIA. And, I mean, he runs everything. The Fort Hood situation, the list just goes on and on. The underwear bomber, the Times Square dud bomb, all of it. He basically finds mentally ill, loose cannon Muslims and then provocateurs them into attacking. So this isn't a purely staged terror attacks. This guy acts as the vehicle, and it came out that Congress has been told it's national security, that they can't see all the emails that the threat fusion centers the feds run knew for 2 years that Major Hassan was going to attack and kill. He thought he was talking to Anwar Al-Awlaki, and he was. And Anwar told him, you know, go ahead and do this attack. And, of course, the Pentagon grabbed the surveillance camera footage from 9/11. Same thing happened in Fort Hood. They grabbed the surveillance camera footage, people's private tapes, private cell phone videos, ordered it all erased. It's always Anwar Al-Awlaki. It's always this guy. It's always him. And we told you, every time he's running the patsies or the dupes, the useful morons. And here's Fox News. It's an exclusive. It's not really an exclusive. We already told you this, but they got the actual documents. The exclusive Al-Qaeda leader dined at the Pentagon just months after 9/11, even though they'd already fingered him in the media as one of the masterminds of 9/11. And it's always the same. These guys, Al-Qaeda is 100% CIA command operation. Sometimes they purely stage attacks or they find useful idiots, but they're being funded by these people.
hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty, and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv. This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones asking you for a minute of your time to tell you about soap. Not detergents, but good old-fashioned pure soap made by the Calbin Soap Company, a family-owned and operated American company. My family, staff, friends, and radio listeners are constantly telling me how much they love these products for bath, hair, laundry, and dishes. There is nothing like these factory-direct, big-money-saving, triple-concentrated soaps anywhere. Get a free detailed catalog by calling 800-340-7091 or see them online at 5starsoap.com or Infowars.com. Let's talk to the owner of 5 Star Soap, Marty Schachter, and see what he has to say.
As founder and owner for over 63 years, people keep asking me, how's business? I'm happy to say our business is going down the drain. Call us at 1-800-340-7091. Visit our website, 5starsoap.com, for buying our 1 to 2 month soap sampler. Thank you.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Okay, coming up in about 5 minutes, we're going to have a former member of the National Security Agency, Naval Intelligence, writes for some of the biggest publications in the country. Wayne Madsen's going to pop in on Anwar Al-Awlaki, or I hear the media pronounce it two different ways, but we've been covering him for at least 5 years as the key CIA, Al-Qaeda handler. And it doesn't matter if it's the underwear bombing, the Times Square attempted bombing, the Fort Hood shooting. It's always this guy running the operation and being protected. And here's the Fox News headline. Exclusive Al-Qaeda leader dined at the Pentagon just months after 9/11. Again, headline. Al-Qaeda leader dined at the Pentagon just months after 9/11. And over the last 5 years, we have written multiple articles yearly at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com fingering him directly and proving that he is a CIA operative. And so we have the new headline out at PrisonPlanet.com today, two articles by Watson, by Paul Watson. Al-Qaeda is a front group for the U.S. military industrial complex. And then it goes through Ahmad Salam. It goes through David Headley, which is now mainstream news, reportedly commanding the Mumbai attacks. We've got Prince Bandar Bush and his comments about it. Osama bin Laden being admitted, CIA, Rashid Aswat masterminding the 7-7, and it came out mainstream news that he was MI6 and being protected. And so there's purely staged events like Gulf of Tonkin or 9/11 or Operation Ajax. or other battle plans that they didn't implement, like Operation Northwoods or USS Liberty, which was implemented. But then there's other events where you have the Western intelligence agencies, MI6 does it, Mossad engages in it, Germans engage in it, the U.S. has been caught over and over again, and they go out and find Klan groups in the U.S. that came out in Texas Monthly back in 1998, that the FBI had created a Klan group and tried to get them to blow stuff up, but they couldn't get them to do it, so they still busted them for it. I mean, you see this over and over and over again. But this particular Anwar Al-Awlaki, he is just one of the most important ones involved in this. And there it is, hidden in plain view, that he met at the Pentagon a couple months after 9/11 with the highest level brass at the event, with the Central Intelligence Agency and with the head of the Army and others. Okay, so this guy is in secret meetings with the top brass. The top brass. He's in secret meetings with them, and then we fast forward 9 years later. Every year since 9/11, he is out there running moron groups, Muslim extremist morons that they can find and set up. And, you know, you take the underwear bomber. We have the witnesses on the plane. The FBI now admits it, an, quote, unnamed U.S. intelligence agency. The deputy head, the deputy secretary of the State Department admitted 2 months after we broke it here with eyewitnesses, and the FBI tried to deny it and went to the lawyers, law firm and tried to tell him to, that he saw incorrectly, and they tried to intimidate other witnesses, that here's the underwear bomber looking drugged, looking out of his mind, disheveled. He has no passport. He has no visa. He can hardly talk. And a sharp-dressed man argues with the people at the gate, because he doesn't even have, any of the stuff to board, and then orders them, you're going to let him on the plane. This guy had so much power, he could order the airport in Amsterdam to put him on the aircraft. And then it comes out, this is 100% admitted, that the State Department was ordered to, quote, help him get on the plane. So you've got the U.S. State Department clearly at the gate getting him through security. By the way, they had naked body scanners in beforehand at that airport. He gets to bypass those. He doesn't have a visa. He doesn't have a passport. He is obviously drugged out of his gourd. There are operatives all over the plane videotaping him the entire flight. They pull everybody off the plane afterwards in Detroit, say that there's bombs, pull everybody out. Then they try to cover that up. It turns out that's a lie. This was a drill. And they had some doped up idiot. And then they put out on television a fake Al-Qaeda video of the underwear bomber with a machine gun at a North African Al-Qaeda training base. And they show him, and it looks like Obi-Wan Kenobi in Empire Strikes Back when he's a ghost. I mean, it's shimmering. It's so fake. I mean, a 10-year-old with video editing software could do this. It's clearly a face they project into somebody else's hood. And the CIA admits they put out fake videos. So it's 100% staged. Okay? You've got, even if you can believe the official story, it just makes me sick. Even if you believe the official Fort Hood story, for 2 years they knew he was planning this and protected him. Now, we're going to go over all of this in this hour. And we've got huge breaking news with Lindsey Williams, who's very shaken up, joining us. His source is dying of terminal cancer, so spilt his guts completely. So that's coming up. And huge revelations if this is accurate. And I have no reason to believe it isn't. But I briefly wanted to bring Paul Watson up just for a couple of minutes. Paul, I know in your articles about this, Al-Qaeda is a front group for the U.S. military-industrial complex. And in your first article of the day, Al-Qaeda mastermind invited to Pentagon after 9/11. And this is down in a leaked report to Fox News. The documents exclusively obtained by Fox News, including an FBI interview conducted after the Fort Hood shooting in November of 2009, state that Al-Awlaki was taken to the Pentagon as part of a military outreach to the Muslim community in the immediate aftermath of the attacks, and met with the senior leadership of the Pentagon and the CIA. I mean, it's the same story with the MI6.